Hi friends, I am Dr. Anshu Sethi, neonatologist from Jahangir Hospital, and today I will be speaking to you on managing a newborn born to a COVID positive mother. As we all know, the pandemic of coronavirus has swept through the entire world. Pregnant women and neonates are especially vulnerable to this infection, with unique challenges in this management. The neonates are primarily infected from the mother through horizontal transmission, that is, through infected droplets and aerosols. However, there is a risk of vertical transmission from the mother to the baby through the infected placenta. However, the commonest route of infection to the newborn is through infected droplets postpartum or postnatally, either through an infected mother, through an infected caregiver, or through an infected parent or any other member in the family. The mode of delivery, either section or a vaginal delivery, does not affect the rate of peripartum transmission from the mother to the neonate. If the mother is COVID positive and delivers an asymptomatic neonate, the neonate is full term and healthy. The baby can be roomed in with the COVID positive mother. There is no risk to the neonate as long as the mother carries out COVID protective behavior, including masking, wearing a double mask, following hand hygiene measures and sanitization. Exclusive breastfeeding should be started as soon as possible to the neonate, and when the baby is not being handled, the baby can be kept at a 6 feet distance from the mother. Exclusive breastfeeding is nowadays recommended even by WHO and AAP, since the risk of viral transmission through breast milk is very, very less, and the protective benefits of breastfeeding, including immunological, developmental, and all the immunological antibodies which come through breast milk to the baby, are immensely beneficial and they outweigh the risk, potential risk of virus transmission. If the mother is COVID positive and is symptomatic or has respiratory problems, then the infant can be shifted to a COVID NICU or an isolation room and can be even given expressed breast milk, which the mother can provide. RT-PCR testing by oropharyngeal or nasopharyngeal swab is recommended in all infants at 24 to 48 hours after birth. If the RT-PCR is negative and the infant is asymptomatic, the infant can be sent home on routine day 3 and kept in home isolation for 14 days with close follow-up for signs and symptoms. The routine vaccination BCG, oral polio and hepatitis B can be given to the neonate before discharge. However, if the RT-PCR of the neonate is positive and the infant is symptomatic, then the infant is kept in a COVID NICU or an isolation room, treated according to the development of symptoms, and vaccination is then deferred for 2 weeks after birth. The onset of symptoms in neonates usually starts at 2 to 7 days after birth, and only 1% of neonates get symptoms. 99% of infants are asymptomatic and RT-PCR negative. Here's a chart showing the symptoms which are there in neonatal COVID. Most of the symptoms in neonates are developing between 2 to 7 days after birth, and this is called as early onset neonatal COVID. In these symptoms, the symptoms can include temperature instability or low grade fever. They may have loss of interest in feeding, that is decreased feeding, lethargy, nasal congestion, mild flaring. And there may be also lethargy included with diarrhea and respiratory symptoms including irregular breathing. A close watch for these symptoms is mandatory, and early treatment results in quick recovery. Late onset neonatal COVID, which is through infected transmitted droplets from the mother or health caregiver, starts between 5 to 35 days after birth. Symptoms may be moderate to severe, including temperature instability, lethargy, respiratory distress, and may include neck-like symptoms, that is necrotizing enterocolitis with abdominal distension. X-rays may show white patches or bilateral haziness, and blood picture may show leukocytosis, lymphopenia and thrombocytopenia. only 0.1% of infants develop the severe syndrome, which is known as multi-system inflammatory syndrome in neonates, MISN, which is a dreaded complication. This includes severe symptoms and develops due to maternal lymphocytes or antibodies which go from the mother to the baby. And this syndrome may include neonatal hyperinflammatory response and causing myocarditis, respiratory failure, and Kawasaki-like syndrome with coronary inflammation. And blood picture shows DIC, rise of inflammatory markers, including thrombocytopenia, neutropenia, and lymphopenia. However, early treatment and diagnosis will cause good response in the babies, and immunoglobulin therapy has been shown to give a good response. Thus, with the anticipated third wave, which predominantly might affect neonates and the pediatric population, preventive strategies play a key role in prevention, starting right from the antenatal period. Mothers are requested not to go in crowded places, avoid baby shower parties, and always wear double mask, use hand sanitization and hand hygiene measures. After delivery of the baby, encouraging breastfeeding, rooming in even if the mother is COVID positive, and using COVID protective behavior will go a long way. Early recognitions of signs symptoms in a COVID positive neonate, early pickup and reporting to the hospital and pediatrician with red flag signs will help us in combating this epidemic. Thank you.